It is time now for Ask the Expert. Dentists are seeing more children with cavities these days.
Luckily, there's a natural sugar that can actually help fight tooth decay. Our registered dietitian, Laurie Meyer, is here with the details. And Laurie, what is this wonderful sugar that actually fights tooth decay?
Well, this natural sugar is called xylitol, and I'm sure a lot of people have already been seeing this because it's been on the market for quite some time. In fact, it was approved for use in the United States in the 1960s. So we've had it, but we're seeing more and more of it on the market, and especially when we get more and more research studies showing that it probably does have some great efficacy, in, especially in terms of fighting tooth decay. It is a sugar alcohol, so it's not exactly a sugar. You just taste it. It's kind of sweet like a sugar. Yeah. It has 40% of the calories. So a teaspoon of sugar has 16 calories, a teaspoon of xylitol, just under 10 calories. But the real benefit here is that it has antimicrobial properties. So it's antibacterial and antifungal. And as a result of that, it's going to help to prevent oral bacteria from forming on the teeth and producing that acid that really causes the cavities. So we're seeing a suppression of oral bacteria. It also stimulates saliva. I need a little bit of that right now. But saliva, we know that also helps to wash away bacteria and helps to prevent cavities. It also improves calcium absorption, which is something very important for both teeth and bone. And we're finding it actually strengthens the tooth and the bone. It helps to remineralize them. So there are some really great properties with the xylitol. And so, you know, dentists are now saying that maybe after every meal, chew xylitol gum or some mints.
What other health benefits, though? There's some additional
things.
There
are. Because it's antimicrobial and antibacterial, they're actually finding that it can help to suppress bacteria in ears and in sinuses, and so it may help to prevent sinus infections and ear infections. There's also some data that may help to reduce asthma, help to reduce allergies, and because it doesn't require or increase a lot of insulin in the body, it has a very low glycemic index of only 7. Mm. It may be good for weight loss, and some diabetics may also benefit from it. So it seems like this can actually be kind of a good sugar. The body naturally produces it in one of its metabolic pathways, so it's not a foreign object either.
Right. So who should stay away from xylitol?
Well, there's a couple of people that probably, they can test it and see if they tolerate it, but because it's a sugar alcohol, it can produce some cramping and diarrhea and gas. So people with irritable bowel syndrome and gallbladder problems, especially gallbladder pain, they already have those symptoms. It might exacerbate and make them worse. But dogs in particular, if you are going to use xylitol, if you're going to eat it, keep it away from your dogs. It does cause liver damage in dogs. They don't have any enzymes to be able to metabolize it.
So real quick, where do you get xylitol?
Unfortunately, it's not in a lot of grocery stores. You probably have to go to a health food store, but most health food stores have it. But what you want to look for are the granules, gums, mints. Toothpaste would be a great thing, and also the sinus sprays. Very more effective than many of the other sprays on the market.
All right. Good to know.
Thank you, Laurie. Got a question for our experts? Email them at AskTheExpert at todaystmj4.com. You can also leave a voicemail number to call 967-5253.